Let's try to solve few problems on gear as well as gear trains. So the first problem here, the statement of the first problem is as given. So you have a single reduction gear, 120 kilowatt with a pinion, 250 mm pitch circle diameter. So the power transmitted by this gear is given, which is 120 kilowatt with a pinion of 250 mm pitch circle diameter. So the smaller gear pitch circle diameter is given, so from that you can even calculate the radius of the pinion, pitch circle radius, and a speed of 650 rpm. So 650 rpm, so n value he has given, is supported in a bearing on either sides. Calculate the total load due to the power transmitted. So you need to calculate what is the total load due to power transmitted, the pressure angle being 20 degree. Now so the datas which are given are listed here. So he has given the power transmitted, which is in kilowatt, it's been converted into watts. So the pitch circle diameter is given, 250 mm. So pitch circle radius would be 125. In terms of meter, it is 0.125 meter, and the speed at which it rotates is 650 rpm. You can even calculate the angular velocity of that, so omega in terms of radians per second. So omega is 2 pi n by 60. So n you have 650, you'll be substituting that here by 60, you get 68 radians per second, and the pressure angle is 20 degree. So he is asking to calculate the total load, okay, due to the power transmitted. So in order to solve this, so with respect to the statement, so he is asking to calculate the total load. So the total load is F here. So the total load transmitted is F. Okay. So you have two components when the power is transmitted from one gear to another gear. You have a tangential load, you have a radial load. Okay, now he is asking to calculate the F value. So now since power is given, okay, power you can use torque into angular velocity, P is equal to T into omega. So power is equal to torque into angular velocity. So power value is given, omega also we have calculated, so you can get the torque. So for torque is equal to your tangential force, okay, this FT into this radius from O1 to P. So O1 to P is your pitch circle radius of the pinion. So that is also there. So you can calculate what is the value of FT. So once you know FT and the component of this force, okay, in x direction here, F into cos 5 is FT. So once you know FT, so FT divided by cos 5 will give you what is the force. So it's a very direct problem. So the first the power has been given, so you will be using torque into angular velocity. So omega value is known and the power value is known, okay, substitute the power value as well as the omega value into this, so you will be getting the unknown, that is torque, so which is 1765 newton per meter. So the power value that you have to substitute is 120 into 10 power 3, and the omega value that you'll be substituting is 68 radians per second. So you'll be getting torque is equal to 1765 newton meter. So from the torque you'll be calculating the tangential force. So corresponding to this figure, so your tangential force FT, okay, into this radius O1 to P is the torque. So your tangential force is torque divided by the radius. So torque value, it's already been calculated, and the radius value is your pitch circle radius. So pitch circle radius is 0.125 meter. So you'll be substituting 0.125 meter. So from that you'll get your tangential force, which is 14,120 newton. So after calculating tangential force, you need the net load. So that is F. So F into cos 5 is tangential force. So if you want F, so tangential force divided by cos 5 you can do. So your the net force is tangential force divided by cos 5. So whatever the tangential force we have got here, using that, and phi is 20 degree. So If you substitute that into this equation, you are going to get the net load which is transmitted is 15,026 Newton. Now, looking at the problem number 2, okay, in the problem number 2, the number of teeth on each of the two equals per gear in mesh are 40. So, he says that there are two spur gears which are in mesh. Each of them have a teeth of 40. Okay, so the number of capital T as well as the small t is 40, which is written here. The teeth have 20 degree involute profile and the module is 6 mm. So, phi is equal to your pressure angle is 20 degree. The module is 6 mm. If the arc of contact is 1.75 times the circular pitch, so the arc of contact is 1.5 times the circular pitch, which you can take it as pi times of module. Find the addendum. It's asking you to calculate the addendum. So we he has given the number of teeth, the pressure angle, the module, and also the arc of contact. So he is asking us to calculate addendum. So now we know that addendum. Okay, so addendum is nothing but your addendum radius minus r, pitch circle radius. So addendum is nothing but the radial distance from the pitch circle to the top of the tooth. Okay, addendum circle. So it is ra minus r. So in this the pitch circle radius, so pitch circle radius for our case, since the module is same, okay, and both the gears are having the same number of teeth, okay, so capital R as well as the small r is same, which is given by m into t by 2. Capital R, okay, of the gear and the small r both are same because the teeth are same, because we are having both have 40 teeth, okay, so capital R and small r would be same. So m into capital T, or even you can substitute small t divided by 2, so you will get the value of r. Module is 6 mm, teeth is 40 divided by 2, will be getting r value, pitch circle radius. And he has given arc of contact. So the arc of contact, okay, if the arc of contact is 1.5 times circular pitch, so length of arc of contact he has already given, which is 1.5 times circular pitch. So for this value, if you can substitute 1.75 times the circular pitch, which is pi times module. So after substituting that, okay, so but your length of arc of contact, okay, your length of arc of contact, your length of arc of contact is equal to your length of path of contact divided by cos 5. So we can use this formula. And the length of path of contact is given by this formula, which is here. You just have to remember this. Now, you know what is the value of, so from this, okay, from this, you know this value, you know cos 5. And the only unknown what you have here is Ra. We need Ra. So Ra has to be obtained from this. Ra has to be obtained from this. So here, in our case, okay, so length of path of contact, you will be knowing length of arc of contact. So the whatever the value you get here, you will be substituting it here. So the only unknown value what we have here is Ra, okay, Ra. So you can, after solving this equation, you can simplify whatever the value of Ra we get, okay, into this to get the addendum. So to solve this, so first we'll try to identify the circular pitch. So circular pitch is pi times of module, which comes to around 18.85 mm. And next is length of arc of contact. He has given 1.75 times the circular pitch. So 1.5 times the 18.85 is 33 mm. Now after that, your length of path of contact is length of arc of contact times cos 5. Okay, so whatever you have got, 33 into cos 20 degree, if you simplify, you get 31 mm. The R value, okay, which is m into capital T by 2 or small t by 2, which is 120 mm. So substituting, so now the next thing is, we'll be using this length of path of contact equation. So this is the length of path of contact equation. And length of path of contact, we've already got it as 31 mm. So substitute that 31 mm we have substituted, and we'll be simplifying for RA. When all the values are known, we'll be just simplifying it for RA. Okay, so RA after simplification, here capital R and small r are same. In the same manner, capital RA square and small RA square, okay, this addendum radius of the wheel and addendum radius of the pinion are same in this case. So your RA, you'll get it as 126.12 mm. So from this, so you can calculate the addendum of the wheel. So if you subtract that addendum radius, okay, minus your pitch circle radius, you'll get the addendum as 6.12 mm. Now we'll consider one more problem. So in this problem, so the pinion is having a 30 teeth, drives a gear having 80 teeth. So the smaller gear has a 30 teeth, so smaller gear is small t, 30 teeth, and it drives a gear having 80 teeth. So capital T, the teeth on the wheel, is 80. The profile of the gear is involute with 20 degree pressure angle. So phi is 20 degree. So 12 mm module and 10 mm module, sorry, 12 mm module and 10 mm addendum. So the gear profile is involute, which is having a module of 12 mm and addendum of 10 mm. You need to find the length of path of contact, arc of contact, and contact ratio. So since so the length of path of contact, we have the equation for length of path of contact. For that, you need the values of RA and R. So to calculate the RA and R value, we can use addendum as well as the teeth, because module is given. Okay, so R is equal to M into capital T by 2. So you'll get capital R. Similarly, small r can be obtained from M into small t by 2. So you'll get small r, and when you add addendum to that, you'll get your addendum radius for both the wheel as well as the pinion. So with that, you can, I think you can calculate what is the length of path of contact. Once you have calculated that, divide that by cos phi, you'll get arc of contact, and your contact ratio is length of arc of contact divided by circular pitch. So circular pitch being pi times of module. We'll see that. So he has asked you, asked us to calculate what is the length of path of contact, length of arc of contact, and contact ratio. So as I told you, length of path of contact, we have this equation. So in this, we need the values of R, A, as well as R. So the radius, pitch circle radius for the smaller gear, pitch circle radius for the bigger gear or the wheel, we can use this. Module is known, teeth are known, and addendum radius, once you know the values of capital R and small r, you can calculate the addendum radius by just adding addendum to that. And once length of path of contact is known, you just divide that by cos 5. So whatever values we have got here, R value, RA, will be substituting it here to get the length of path of contact. So once this is obtained, so divide this value by cos 5, we'll be getting arc of contact. So later, divide that by circular pitch, you'll get the contact ratio, which gives you number of teeth which are in contact. So as you can see, the pitch circle radius of the pinion, M into T by 2. Okay, so this was 30 and module was 12. Okay, so it is 12 times, this is 12 into 30. Okay, this is 12 into 30, it is not 1230, it is 12 into 30 by 2, you get 180. And capital R is, again, this is 12 into 80 by 2, which is 480. And you just add addendum to that, which is 10 mm. So you get the addendum radius. So once you know the values of RA and R, it substituting that, you get the length of path of contact as 52.3 mm. So divide this by cos 5, okay, you get 55.66 mm, which is length of arc of contact. And this length of arc of contact divided by circular pitch. So circular pitch is pi times of module. Okay, circular pitch is pi times of module. Module is the module for this is 12. So pi times, when you do that, you get the contact ratio, which comes to around 1.5. Okay, so the number of teeth in contact at any given point of time, you're getting 1.5 teeth. So it cannot be so. As a result of which, it always have to be a whole number. So it is approximated to 2. So the next problem, so in this you have to determine the minimum number of teeth which is required on the pinion, okay, in order to avoid interference. So this pinion, okay, is in mesh with a gear, okay, is the condition, there are two conditions I have been given. So to avoid interference, which is to gear with or mesh with a wheel to give a gear ratio of 3:1. So the gear ratio he has given, G value is 3, and it is also, it the pinion also needs to mesh with one more gear, such that an equal wheel means your gear ratio will be 1. Okay, so there are two conditions which are given. What is the minimum number of teeth on this pinion, okay, such that when it meshes with one of the gear, its gear ratio is 3, and when it meshes with other gear, its gear ratio is 1. In such cases, what should be the minimum number of teeth? The pressure angle is 20 degrees, and addendum he has given, a standard addendum of the pinion is 1 module. Okay, it may be assumed. So you have a direct formula for minimum number of teeth. Okay, so you have the gear ratio here. So the gear ratio is capital T by small t, the pressure angle, the addendum. So coming to problem number 4, here, okay, the problem statement goes like this. Determine the minimum number of teeth required on the pinion in order to avoid interference, which is to gear with, first condition, a wheel to give a gear ratio of 3:1, and the second condition, an equal wheel. The pressure angle is 20 degrees, and a standard addendum of 1 module for the wheel may be assumed. So according to this problem, so you have to find the minimum number of teeth on the pinion. In the first case, it is meshing with one more gear, which is having a gear ratio of 3:1. And in the second case, it is meshing with the wheel, okay. So in this case, he says that it is equal wheel, which means that the gear ratio will be 1. The pressure angle is 20 degrees, okay, and the addendum would be of the pinion is 1 module. Okay, so this is a very straightforward problem where you just have to substitute in the equation for minimum number of teeth in the pinion to avoid interference. So the first case, okay, in the first case when it is meshing with the wheel, and it is giving a gear ratio of 3:1. So the minimum number of teeth on the pinion, you have this equation. So we have the values for AP, okay, and the values for G also. What is the gear ratio? This is 3, you will be substituting. This is 1, you will be substituting it as. So after substitution, okay, after substitution, so the phi is also 20 degrees. So after substitution, you'll get the values. It has 15.04. So it has to be a whole number to avoid interference. You cannot keep it at 15. Okay, so this is the minimum value. You cannot have a value lesser than this. So anything value higher than this is 16. The next whole number 16. So similarly, when the pinion is meshing with one more gear, giving a gear ratio of 1, okay, so in such case, using the same formula, So you will get 12.34, which can be approximated to 13. So coming to the next problem, so the statement goes like this: the gearing of a machine tool is shown in the figure. Okay, so the figure is somewhat like this. In the figure, okay, the motor shaft is connected to the gear A and rotates at 975 rpm. So the motor shaft is connected to gear A and this rotates at 975 rpm. Okay, the gear wheel B, C, D and E are fixed to a parallel shafts rotating together. So B, C, D, E are fixed to a parallel shaft which rotate together. Fine. So you have a shaft. So on this shaft you have two gears which are on the same shaft, two gears have been used, and on this also you have two gears which are used. So the speed of C as well as B is same, the speed of E and D also will be same. The final gear F is fixed on the output shaft. What is the speed of the gear F? The number of teeth on each of the gear A, B, C, D, E, F respectively are 20, 50, 25, 75, 26 and 65. So this is the arrangement. As you can see here, so the power is transmitted from shaft or gear A to gear F. So it's again it's a very simple problem. So here your velocity ratio or the speed ratio, okay, so NA by NF you can write down. Okay, so your speed ratio is velocity of the driver, this is the driver and this is the driven, of the first driver and the last driven. Okay, so speed of the driver divided by speed of the driven will be equal to product of number of teeth on the driven divided by number of teeth on the driver. So we can use that equation to find out the value of NF. So initial speed of the gear A is given 975, and the values of number of teeth on each of the gear is being given. So speed of the driver divided by speed of driven is product of number of teeth on the driven divided by product of number of teeth on the driver. So which is NA by NF is now talking about the number of teeth on the driven. Okay, so now gear A is meshing with gear B. So A is the driver, B is the driven, and on the shaft, okay, we have both the gears B and C, but in this case the shaft C is in contact, or is it is meshing with gear D. So C is the driver and D is the driven, and again the motion from the gear D, since D and E are on the same shaft, they'll be rotating at same speed, and E is the driver and E is the driven. So the product of number of teeth on the driven, so the driven is B, okay, and the driven would be D as well as the driven would be F. So B, D and F, and the remaining would be driver. So that you will be substitute, so you have all the values here, so the only unknown value is NF. So after simplifying, you will get the value at as 52 rpm. So let's discuss one more problem on gear trains. And here, so the statement of the problem goes like this: the speed ratio of a reverted gear train is as shown in the figure, and the speed ratio to be 12. So this is the gear train, reverted gear train. The speed ratio is 12, so it means that the speed of the driver by speed of the driven is 12. NA by ND is 12. The module pitch of the gear A and B is 3.125. So the module of gear A as well as B is 3.125, And the module for gear C and D is 2.5. The module for gear C as well as D is 2.5. Calculate the suitable number of teeth for the gear. No gear is to have less than 24 teeth. So he has given the module and what is the speed ratio and minimum teeth, okay, not lesser than 24. So this being the diagram, and the center distance between the shafts has been given 200. So what we can do is, so the gear A is meshing with gear B, and gear C is meshing with gear D, and both the gears B and C are on the same shaft, so it means that they are same speed. Speed of B is equal to speed of C, and also the speed ratio is given for the entire gear train, so NA by ND is 12. So if we write the speed ratio of this reverted gear train, so we can write it as NA by N, because A is meshing with B, so NA by NB into NC is meshing with D, so into NC by ND, that should be equal to 12. So now, so this is the speed ratio, NA by ND is 12, their modules have been given. As I told you, NA by NB into NC by ND should be equal to 12. In that case, okay, so if you individually calculate what is the speed ratio of A and B or C and D, so that will be square root of 12. Okay, so that would be square root of 12. How it is square root of 12? So NA by NB into NC by ND, okay, is equal to square root of 12 into square root of 12, if you can do, so you get it as 12. Now here, we have come to know what is the speed ratio of these two meshed gear, so it comes to around 3.464. Now this speed ratio NA by NB, okay, is inversely proportional to their teeth, number of teeth on them. So NA by NB is equal to NB by NA. So here also you get the ratio of teeth NB by NA as well as TD by TC corresponding to this. So that also is 3.464. Now since the center distance is given, so we have the center distance, so the radius of A plus radius of B should be equal to radius of C plus radius of D, which is 200 mm. So that is written down here. So now we know the module, okay, we know what is the module. So module of A, module of B is known. So this is R is your pitch circle radius, so you can express the pitch circle radius in terms of module and teeth. So that is, you can express the pitch circle radius in terms of module and teeth. So that would be RA would be MATA by 2. Similarly, you can write down the equations for other also. Now, since we know the module, okay, so the module of all the gears has been known, okay, so, and we know what should be the, this is 200. So here the module is also known, 3.125. Okay, 3.125 this, and module for C and D is 2.5. So after simplifying, you get the number of teeth on gear A plus number of teeth on gear B is 128. Similarly for C and D, when you add, it is 160. So these two equations, along with that, this equation, okay, using these three equations, okay. So here you can express, let us say TB. TB is equal to 3.464 times TA, or TD is equal to 3.464 times TC. So you can use that and substitute it to this equation. You can substitute for TB in terms of TA, and you can substitute for TD in terms of TC. So after substituting, okay, you will get an equation only in terms of TA. So substitute for TA, so TA you will be getting 28.67. So you can approximate it to 28, because he says that the minimum number of teeth should not be lesser than 24, okay, so it has been taken as 28. And once this is 28, so TA is 28, so naturally TA plus TB should be 128, so TB becomes 100. So similarly, simplify for TC, so TC would be 35.84, and it can be taken as 36, okay, or even number. Now, so substituting 36 here, the TD would be 124. So what he has asked in the problem is to calculate the number of teeth on the gear. So the number of teeth on all the gear, TA, TB, TC and TD. And the condition given is, in no gear, okay, the number of teeth should be lesser than 24. So you don't have any teeth, any gear on which the number of teeth is 24. So that was reverted gear train, a problem on reverted gear train. Now let's look into a problem on epicyclic gear train. So in an epicyclic gear train, the arm carries two gears A and B having 36 and 45 teeth. So the number of teeth on gear A and gear B are 36 and 45. If the arm rotates at 150 rpm, so here the arm is C, it is rotating at 150 rpm in the anti-clockwise direction. So it is anti-clockwise, okay, so anti-clockwise will consider it as to be positive. About the center of the gear A, which is fixed, he says that the gear A is fixed, so NA would be 0. Determine the speed of gear B. That is the first condition. When the gear A is fixed, you have to find out the speed of gear B. If the gear A, instead of being fixed, makes 300 rpm, this is the second condition. If it makes 300 rpm in the clockwise direction, so NA, you have to take it as minus 300 rpm. What will be the speed of gear B? So you have to find out NB. To find out this, so this is the arrangement. You have two gears A and B, and this is the arm. So initially the gear A is fixed, and the arm is making certain amount of rotation in counterclockwise direction. So in that case, what is the speed of gear B? And in the second case, when the arm A, sorry, when the gear A is also rotating, okay, so what is the speed of gear B? So we'll use the tabular method for this. So in the tabular method, so there are three elements. The element is gear A, gear B and gear C. There are three elements. So we will write down those three elements. So arm, gear A and gear B. Now, first thing what we'll do is we'll fix the arm. We'll assume that the arm is fixed and we'll rotate. Give one rotation for gear A. The arm is fixed, so the motion corresponding to arm is 0, and we'll give one rotation to gear A in the anticlockwise direction. So plus 1. So when you give one rotation to gear A in anticlockwise direction, the gear B will rotate in the opposite direction. Okay, so opposite direction, and its speed of the gear B, NB, would be TA by TB times NA. So that is written here. TA by TB times NA. NA is 1 here. In the R case, since it is 1, okay. Now, in the second row, we'll assume that the arm is fixed, but instead of giving one rotation to the gear A, we'll give X rotation to gear A. In such a case, okay, when arm being fixed, so arm is fixed, you give X rotation to gear A, then the speed of the gear B would be minus X times of TA by TB. And individually, we'll give Y rotation to each of the element, so that is added here. So if that's the case, so the net rotation, okay, so the net rotation or the motion of the arm, you just add up all the column here, these two, okay, only these two. So it would be Y, so this is X plus Y, and Y minus X into TA by TB. Now what he has, the first condition is, he says that the gear A is fixed, okay, and if the arm rotates 150 rpm, and the gear A is fixed, so Y is 150 and X plus Y is 0, the first condition, okay, so Y is 150 So this is the arm rotation in anti-clockwise direction, so positive. X plus y would be the speed of the gear A. So he says that gear A is fixed, so it is 0. So when y is 150, you will come to know what is the value of x. So x comes out to be minus 150 rpm. In that case, so once you know the value of x as well as y, okay, so he is asking you to find the what is the speed of the gear B. So this would be the speed of the gear B. So y minus x into TA by TB. So speed of gear B is y minus x into TA by TB. So we know the value of y, okay, as well as x also. So x is equal to minus 150, y is equal to plus 150. So it turns out to be 270 rpm. So we have a positive value, which means that the gear B will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. Now in the second case, let's see here. In the second case, he says that gear A, instead of being fixed, makes 300 rpm in clockwise direction. So what is the speed of gear B? So it is making 300 rpm. Gear A is making 300 rpm. So x plus y is equal to minus 300, and the y remains as it is, plus 150. You need to find out this. So speed of gear B when gear A makes 300 rpm clockwise. So when gear A is, so the revolution of gear A, the motion of gear A is given by, or NA is x plus y, which is minus 300, because it is rotating in clockwise. And we know the value of y also. Y is minus 150, so x turns out to be minus 450 rpm. So when you know the values of x and y, so the speed of gear B, which is y minus x into TA by TB, which comes out to be, after substituting the value of number of teeth on gear A and B, 510 rpm, okay, with a positive sign. So since it is positive, we can take it as anticlockwise. Now we'll see one more problem on reverted gear train, reverted epicyclic gear train. So here, in a reverted epicyclic gear train, the arm A carries two gears, B and C, and a compound gear, DE. The gear B meshes with gear E, and gear C meshes with gear D. The total number of teeth on the gear B, C, D are 75, 30, and 90 respectively. Find the speed and the direction of the gear C when gear B is fixed and the arm A makes 100 rpm. So the number of teeth have been given. So the speed of arm is given, it's clockwise, so you can put it minus 100. And he's asking you to calculate what is the speed of gear C under the condition that gear B is fixed and A is making 100 rpm clockwise. So this is the schematic arrangement. You have an arm on which two gears have been mounted, so C as well as B, and this is the compound gear train. On a single shaft you have two gears which is mounted. So the gear B is meshing with gear E and D is meshing with C. So let's the number of elements you have in this problem is, you have an arm, which is the first element, and the second element you have this gear C, and one more element, gear B, and one more element is this compound gear DE. So there are totally four elements. So we'll write these elements in the table. So this is a tabular which is written corresponding to arm, the compound gear, gear B, and gear C. Now what he has asked is to find out the speed of C when B is fixed. Okay, so in such a case, since he has asked for C itself and B is fixed, so the only thing what we can do is we can give only rotations to compound gear. So that is why compound gear is written in the second column here. Now before moving into the table, let's try to find out the teeth on the remaining gear. So as you can see here, Okay, so we can take the radius of C plus radius of D will be equal to radius of E plus radius of B. So that is the case. So radius also can be written in terms of diameter. So it's written here. So this pitch circle radius is proportional to the teeth. Okay, so they can be represented in terms of teeth. So here the number of teeth on three gears are given. So the number of teeth only unknown is number of teeth on gear E. So that we'll write down, and after calculation we'll get it as 45. So coming into this table, so in the first row, what we'll do is we'll assume that the arm is fixed. We'll give one rotation to the compound gear. When one rotation is given to the compound gear, so what will be the speed of gear B and gear C? So one rotation is given to compound gear. So in that case, okay, in anti-clockwise direction, so in such a case, so the gear B will rotate in clockwise. So that would be TE by TB. So that would be TE by TB. Similarly, coming to gear C, so when you give one rotation in the anti-clockwise direction for this compound gear, so D is in meshing with C, so the speed of C would be minus TD by TC. Okay, TD by TC. Now, instead of giving one rotation to the compound gear, we'll give X rotation. Arm being fixed, so arm being fixed, X rotation for compound gear. In such a case, what is the speed of gear B as well as gear C? So individually, we'll be giving Y rotation individually to each of the elements. And to find out the net effect after giving such a motion, you will just add up the elements in row 2 and row 3. So the total motion of the arm is plus y, the total motion of the compound gear x plus y, and the total motion of the gear B as well as gear C. We'll be adding these two. Now let's see the condition what he has asked. So he has asked for NC, NB is 0, NA is minus 100. He has asked for NC, NB is 0, and the arm rotation he has given. So the arm is, sorry, NA is minus 100. It is arm, okay? So the arm is minus 100. So this becomes Y. So Y is minus 100 and NB is 0. NB, this is 0, okay? And so Y is minus 100. This is 0, so you have you know the values of TE and TB, so you can calculate the value of X. Once the value of X is calculated, you know everything, even Y is already known. You can calculate the value of speed of gear C. So Y would be known, X is known, number of teeth on gear D as well as C would be known, so you can calculate this. So since gear B is fixed, so this is the expression for gear B. So you can see here, gear B expression. So that is 0. The Y value for the arm is minus 100. So using these two equations, we'll get what is the value of X, which is minus 166.67. So substituting this value of X as well as Y into the speed of C, so the speed with which the gear C will rotate in C is this equation. So in that equation, the value for Y, X has been substituted, so you get plus 400 rpm. So you're getting a positive value, which means that it rotates in anti-clockwise direction.